So systematic listing is a technique that we use to list all the possible combinations or outcomes in a specific situation in an organised way. And by using it, it ensures that no combination or outcome is missed out. So looking at this first example, we've got the Billy is going to roll a six-sided die and flip a coin. The die can land on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6. And the coin can land on heads or tails. So we need to list all the possible outcomes. So the way we're going to do this systematically is just start with the coin landing on heads. And then we're going to note down all the possible outcomes for the roll of the die. So our first outcome would be that we flip the coin, it lands on heads, and we get a 1 on the die. And now we're going to keep heads the same, and then we're going to find all the other combinations that the die could land on. So we could have heads with a 2, heads with a 3, heads with 4, heads with 5, and then heads with 6. And now we've reached all the possible combinations that could include heads. We then simply move on to tails, and we do exactly the same thing. So we could flip the coin and get a tails, and roll the die and get a 1. And then we just repeat the process. We could get tails with a 2, tails with a 3, tails with a 4, tails with a 5, and then finally tails with a 6. So those would be all our possible outcomes when we flip a coin and roll a die. We have 12 outcomes in total, and this can be found by multiplying the outcomes of each individual event. So there was 2 possible outcomes for the coin flip, and there were 6 possible outcomes for the roll of the die. So when we do 2 multiplied by 6, that gives us 12. So that's where our 12 total possible outcomes comes from. Okay, let's look at this next example. So here we're given 4 number cards, 1, 2, 5 and 8. We need to write down all the possible 4-digit numbers that can be made using these cards, and we can only use each card once. So the way we can do this systematically is to do them in order of size. We can start with the 1, and then we can find all the other combinations that would come after with 1 at the beginning. So let's start with the combination we were given. We've got 1, 2, 5 and 8. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to keep my 1 the same. I'm also going to keep the 2 the same. And then I'm just going to swap around this 5 and this 8. So we'd have 1, 2, 8, then 5. So keeping 1 at the front again, we're now going to look at the next highest number up, which would be our 5. So now I'm going to put 5 as the second digit. And then I'd have 2 and 8 left over. So let's put them in order of size. We'll put the 2 and then the 8. But we can also swap these digits around as well. So we could have 1, 5, 8, then 2. And then moving on, we've got 1 at the front again. But now we can have 1 and then 8. So if we've got 1 and 8, we've got 2 and 5 left over. So we could have 1, 8, 2, 5. But we can also swap those 2 digits around as well. So we would have 1, 8, 5, and then 2. And that'd be all our combinations with 1 as the first digit. So now we're going to move on to 2, where that would be at the front. So we're going to start with 2, and then I'm going to do them in order of size. So we've got 1, 5, and then 8. So now I'm going to keep the 2 and 1 at the front and just swap the 5 and 8 around. So we've got 2, 1, 8, and then 5. So we're going to keep 2 at the front again. We've done all the 1s. So then the next digit we're going to do is 5 next. So if we've got 2 and 5, the remaining digits would be 1 and 8. And then I can just swap these two over again. So I'd have 2, 5, 8 and 1. And then for our last number with 2 at the front, we could have 2. Then we'd have 8 as our next digit. That leaves 1 and 5. So we'd have 2, 8, 1, 5. Then swapping those last two digits, we'd have 2, 8, 5. 1. We can then move on to our numbers with 5 as the first digit. So we'd have 5, 1, 2, and then 8 in order of size. So now we can keep the 5 and 1 at the front and just swap these last two. So we'd have 8, then 2. So we're going to have 5 at the front again. We've done 1. We now move on to 2. So we'd have 5, 2, 1, 8. And then swapping those last two digits again, we'd have 5, 2, 8 and 1. And then lastly, for our fives, we'd have 5, then 8. Well, that would leave us with 1 and 2. So then all we have to do is swap those last two again. So we'd have 5, 8, 2, and 1. And then for our last lot of numbers, we would have 8 as the first digit. So with all the other digits in order of size, we'd have 8, 1, 2, 5. So keeping the 8 and 1 the same, we can swap the 2 and 5. So we've got 8, 1, 5, 2. We'd then have 8, then 2. And we'd be left with 1 and 5. So swapping those digits, we'd have 8, 2, 5, then 1. And then finally, we'd have 8, then 5. So we'd be left with 1 and 2. And swapping these last two digits one final time, we'd have 8, 5, 2, and 1. So we've gone from the smallest number to the largest number in a systematic way. And if we count all them, we've actually got 24 combinations. And we can find that by multiplying the outcomes for each event. Because to begin with, we've got a choice of 4 numbers to pick from. So once we've picked our first number, we've then got a choice of 3 numbers. So then we'd multiply by 3. Then we've got a choice of 2 numbers. So we'd multiply by 2. And then there's 1 final number. So we multiply by 1. So if we do 4 times 3, we get 12. Times by 2 gives us 24. Which when multiplied by 1 is still 24. So that's why there are 24 total outcomes. Okay, let's take a look at one final example. So for this question, we have that there are 3 cards in box A and 3 cards in box B. Sarah takes 1 card from each box and multiplies the numbers together to get a total score. Work out the probability that the total score is an even number. So for this question, we need to list these numbers systematically and figure out the total scores that Sarah would have got. So we can start with box A. We'll do them in order of size. So we can say that Sarah could have picked number 1 from box A and then 4 from box B. And then sticking with 1 from box A, she could have got 5 from box B. And then again, 1 from box A, she could have picked 7 from box B. So that's all the combinations from box A where we've picked the number 1. We're then going to move on to the 3. So we can have 3 from box A, 4 from box B, 3 from box A, 5 from box B, and 3 from box A, 7 from box B. And then finally, we'll have 6 from box A, 4 from box B, 6 from box A, 5 from box B, and then 6 from box A, and 7 from box B. So those are all the possible combinations. But it says once that Sarah has pulled these numbers from each box, she multiplies them together to get a total score. So we now need to multiply all of our pairs together to get our total scores. So starting with the first one, we've got 1 multiplied by 4, which is 4. 1 times 5 is 5. And 1 times 7 is 7. We've then got 3 times 4, which is 12. 3 times 5, which is 15. And then 3 times 7, which is 21. We've then got 6 times 4, which is 24, 6 times 5, which is 30, and finally 6 times 7, which is 42. So those are the total scores from the combinations that she could potentially pick. The question asks us, though, to figure out the probability that the total score is an even number. So to figure out the probability of picking an even number, all we need to find is the total scores that are even and put that in a fraction over the total number of combinations. Well, if we count all of them up, we can see that there's a total of 9 combinations, so our fraction is going to be out of 9. And now what we need to do is find out how many total scores come out to be even. So going through our total scores, we've got 4, well, that's even, 5 is odd, 7 is odd, 12 is even, 15 is odd, 21 is odd, 24 is even, 30 is even, and 42 is even. So we've got 5 combinations that come out to be even. So our probability that the total score is even would be 5/9. So well done if you followed along with those questions. And that's it for this video. If you want to check out any other videos relevant to this one, then I'll leave some links for them down in the description. And I'll also put a card in the top corner. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics at all that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.